Thank you for inviting me to address you on this very important topic of the controlled demolition of the World Trade Center Twin Towers. The fact of the demolition of these buildings has been consistently denied by all government and mass media since the day of the attack. The New York Times writing the day after the attack that, quote, hijackers rammed jetliners into each of New York's World Trade Center towers yesterday, toppling both in a hellish storm of ash, glass, smoke, and leaping victims, as if the plane crashes and the subsequent collapses of these huge skyscrapers were the same event. However, there were 56 and 102 minutes between the times of the jetliner crashes and the respective collapses of the towers. So what actually happened on 9/11/01 is that we had the three most destructive events were the total collapse of World Trade Center Building 2, the South Tower, total collapse of the North Tower about a half an hour later, and 7 hours after that, the implosion of World Trade Center Building 7. The official story would have you to believe that these three events were all the consequences, directly or indirectly, of the plane crashes. My job today is to convince you that these were controlled demolitions, which is a very important point because the realization that these buildings came down not as a result of the jet crashes that were supposedly piloted by suicide extremists, Islamists who attacked us because they hated us, it completely invalidates the entire official story because in order to accomplish the controlled demolition of these buildings, it was necessary to have access to the underlying infrastructure of the building to get to the columns of the buildings in order to bring them down. Osama bin Laden didn't have that access. There's no conceivable way he could have. It proves that the entirety of the 9/11/01 attack was an inside job. Now, I'm using a set of slides here that is more extensive than the talk I'm going to be giving, so I'm going to be zooming into a few parts of this presentation. I'm going to make several major points. One, that the official investigations are fraudulent and entailed criminal destruction of evidence. Two, that Building 7 was demolished by controlled demolition. I'll spend very little time on that, but I'll spend a lot of time on providing evidence that the Twin Towers were demolished through controlled demolition, looking at three aspects to that. Number one, the official explanations are ludicrous. They don't explain the total collapse of these buildings by any stretch. Number two, the evidence indicates demolition. When you look at the physical features of the collapses, they have all the signature features of controlled demolition. How likely is it that they could have been brought down any other way if those features never show up in any event other than controlled demolition? So you have three buildings that show all those aspects. And third, there are simple proofs that demonstrate that these buildings could only have come down through controlled demolition. Now, so to the first part, which was about the need for an investigation and what was actually done instead of an investigation. The nature of these events warranted the most serious, painstaking, careful investigation probably in the history of any incident in the world within the logic of the official story, which is that these three buildings just crumbled as a result of horrible structural failures. Because when you compare what happened to those buildings to all the engineering history of steel frame buildings, which has been in use for over 100 years, there's nothing that even looks remotely like these. Even buildings destroyed by earthquakes, steel frame buildings sometimes topple in response to very severe earthquakes. Sometimes it knocks them off their foundation. There's large portions of buildings maybe lying on the street, but it doesn't produce anything that looks like ground zero, which basically looks like a crater. The buildings were shredded, it smoked for months. No natural cause, fires, earthquakes, anything, can create a result like that. So there's never been any a natural force that can completely destroy skyscrapers except for earthquakes, and they don't produce that kind of destruction. But on 9/11/01, we're supposed to believe that it was fires primarily that brought down these buildings. That, too, is inconsistent with engineering history, because if you look at any of a number of examples, like the 91 One Meridian Plaza fire in Philadelphia, it burned for 18 hours, gutted 8 floors of this building, didn't even damage a vertical column of this building, nor did the severe fires that burned in the First Interstate Bank building in Los Angeles even damage a single vertical column of these buildings. So certainly, it's given how far these events were from anything you would expect to happen from those causes, it justified the most concerted investigation, which is about the opposite of what actually happened, because FEMA took over the site. That's the Federal Emergency Management Agency, and they assembled their own investigative team from the American Society of Civil Engineers. But this was an investigation in name only because the investigators didn't have subpoena power. They weren't even allowed access to the crime scene except for what was described as a guided tour. They only looked at a few pieces of steel at the salvage yards. They didn't even get access to the engineering drawings of the building initially, it looks like. They saved 156 pieces from the millions of pieces at Ground Zero for further study. And when their investigation was over, they wrote up a report. It was published on May of 2002, and it called for further research, investigation, and analysis. But how interesting that by the time this report was published, Ground Zero had been systematically scrubbed. The steel was removed from the site. The city accepted a plan from Controlled Demolition Incorporated for removing and recycling the steel. A mere 11 days after the attack, it was sold to scrap metal for low cost, sold to companies that then sold it to India and China. And the steel was rapidly loaded onto barges and ships and shipped out to mostly to Asia. Some of the steel went through the salvage yards, but it's not clear how much. The net result was that there's basically nothing left of all the structural steel, the thing that you'd want to look at to figure out what happened to these buildings. Now, so there's no real investigation, and there was an investigation later by NIST, which I'll talk about a little bit later. But first of all, I'm next going to go through and just very briefly look at Building 7, which is a building in World Trade Center by address only because it was across the street from the Twin Towers. And when this building came down, 5:20 in the afternoon, just suddenly, precipitously glided into its footprint with all the features of a controlled demolition. So I don't think there's that much to say about Building 7. I mean, if anybody who's seen a controlled demolition of a large building and then watches the video of Building 7 and sees the precise way in which this building went straight down and the speed at which it went down, meaning that virtually all the resistance in the building had been eliminated, and the fact that it created this very tidy rubble pile, all the things that a controlled demolition seeks to achieve through precise placement and timing of explosives. So that said, let's move on to the Twin Towers, because whereas I find that people relatively easily understand that Building 7 was a demolition, just because it looks so much like a conventional demolition, I find that people have much more resistance to understanding that the collapses of the Twin Towers were a demolition, because they don't look exactly like a conventional demolition. For one thing, they exploded from the top down, not the bottom up, and they exploded out with a huge amount of energy. The main difference between the way the Twin Towers were destroyed and a conventional demolition is that much more energy was used to destroy the Twin Towers, so it was more of a demolition event. So the next thing that I want to look at is the official explanations for the collapses of the Twin Towers. I'll just run through these really quickly and point out why they don't explain the collapses. And in this section, I'm going to just be considering the issue of total collapse of these buildings in the abstract, not looking at all the physical features, but just asking, is there any way that the plane crashes and fires could have totally collapsed these buildings? Well, all of the official explanations, all the government reports and all mainstream news media have embraced a whole series of explanations, and they all have in common that there's basically this idea of a pancake theory, a chain, domino effect chain reaction of the building crushing itself from the top to the bottom. And the most ludicrous version of this is the idea that the fires melted the cores of the steel core columns of the building and that caused them to come down. That theory isn't embraced by an official government report. So I'll go on and talk about the more serious theories, like the column failure theory, which was endorsed by a scientific paper that was published on September 13th, 2001. So one wonders what kind of peer review process was subjected to, but this paper really doesn't reveal anything but the author's ignorance of the design of these buildings and of structural engineering in general, because they seem to suggest that building over design ratios, that's the added strength that a building is built with above and beyond what it's expected to meet and it's the most serious forces that it's expected to encounter, are more like 5 to 1 or 10 to 1, not 2 to 1.